Chromosome abnormalities in embryos is the single biggest cause of reproductive failure. Simply put, embryos with chromosome abnormalities almost never implant, and when they do, they almost always miscarry. Most of the time, these abnormalities come from eggs. But what about the sperm? Are men ever responsible for chromosome abnormalities? If so, are there certain factors in men that make them more likely to create chromosomally abnormal embryos? A new study helps us to answer those questions. Stay tuned. Hi, everybody. Dr. Randy Morris here for Infertility TV. I am filming these episodes here at the Anaheim Convention Center at the annual meeting of the American Society for Reproductive Medicine. A healthy, normal human embryo has 46 chromosomes, 23 from the sperm and 23 from the egg. Sometimes, however, embryos can have extra chromosomes and sometimes they have missing chromosomes. We have known for some time that as women get older, they produce more embryos with chromosome abnormalities. When we do IVF, embryos are created in the laboratory and they can be tested to see if they have the correct number of chromosomes. This is known as PGTA, or pre-implantation genetic testing for aneuploidy. If there is an abnormality in the number of chromosomes, we can also tell if it came from the mother or the father. In a recent study, they determined that in about 75% of the abnormal embryos, the abnormality originated from the maternal side only. About 8% of the abnormalities came from the male side, and about 8% of the abnormalities came from a combination of the male and female. No new information so far. This group, however, did some additional analyses in those cases in which the abnormality only came from the male side. They looked at three factors. First, they looked at whether having an abnormal semen analysis was more likely to produce abnormal embryos. Remember, a semen analysis looks at the number of sperm, the percentage of moving sperm, and the percentage of sperm with an abnormal shape under the microscope. They found that the semen analysis results did not predict abnormal embryos. Even when they looked at the most severely abnormal results, men with very low sperm numbers, they still did not produce more abnormal embryos. A question I get frequently is whether men with a lot of abnormal appearing sperm are more likely to produce abnormal embryos. Now we can confidently answer that question. No. Second, the researchers looked at men who were overweight or obese. We know that obese men produce less pregnancies than their partners, but could part of the reason be that they produced more abnormal embryos? The answer is no. Obese men did not make more abnormal embryos than normal weight men. Finally, they looked at male age. They compared men who were under age 50 to men over age 50. Again, no difference in the percentage of embryos with abnormal chromosomes was found. Our Infertility TV bottom line is this. Overall, men alone are responsible for less than 10% of chromosomally abnormal embryos. Men who are older, weigh more, or have an abnormal semen analysis are not more likely to produce abnormal embryos. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.